Today I'm going to show you how to take vintage linens and upcycle them into a beautiful wall hanging using the Quilted to Go method and using the decorative stitches on your sewing machine. Hi, I'm Kim Jamison Hurst of Chatterbox Quilts, and you may have some vintage linens that you've inherited or that you've picked up at estate sales like I do, and you're wondering what to do with them. They're gorgeous, but maybe you don't need a table runner or an antimacassar on your couch or chairs. So what can you do to show off these beautiful hand-embroidered pieces? Well, I've got a solution for you. I want to show you how you can make a wall hang or even a quilt block using the vintage linen as the centerpiece and then adding strips around it with the quilt as you go method and then further embellishing it by using the decorative stitches on your sewing machine. So the one that I have here, and I'll just move it around here a bit. It's always hard to tell which is the top on this one, but I guess that's a good thing if it doesn't really matter which direction. But this one here was part of a table runner. And I really like the look of it, and again, didn't know what to do with it. This particular one, some of the stitching has come off, but I have another section that's pristine, and I wanted to use this one first as a prototype, and actually it worked out really well. I really like it. Now, it's about 20 inches square, so it's a good size, and that is because of the size of the design I started with, of course. So this is about a 9.5 inch piece that I started with in the center, and then, of course, as you add to it, it just gets bigger and bigger, right? But you could start with something smaller. So for example, maybe you have some handkerchiefs. Most of those, I think, have handkerchiefs left over or donated or, you know, passed down by someone in the family. So I've got this little handkerchief here. Now, I'm not gonna make this 9.5 inches to start in the center because all I'm gonna get is an awful lot of white fabric. So I'm gonna do something smaller. And what I like to use, you can use different things to cut out your centerpiece, different notions. You could use a square ruler. So if I wanted to cut this, say, 4 inches, I would just line up my 4-inch lines along the side here. Have to go down and find my size here to get the right square. Always challenging for me. But if you're good at this, you could do this. Since I'm not good at it, I need a little bit of help. And what I like to use is the Martelli Fussy Cut Windows. They come in different sizes, different sets. Each set has 4 different sizes in it. And if I was going to use this hanky, for example, I would probably use a 3.5 inch size. And I'm just gonna line it up along the edge. I wanna make sure I catch all the fabric in there, of course. So I could really make it any size I want. But if I use the 3.5, then I would take the no-slip square template and put it in the center and just remove this and cut it out. If you're wondering about what I'm talking about with these fussy cut window templates, you can check above or in the description below, and I'll have a link on a video I've done to explain how these work. But I use them all the time, and for this particular situation, super handy. So you may be using a handkerchief, right? Or you may be using something like this other one that I have, which has already been partially cut out, actually. I guess it's like a handkerchief. It's hard to tell exactly what it was, but you can see there's some markings on it. All right, so there is some, I think at least one of them that doesn't have that on it. That's, you know, good enough I could use, if you will. So if I wanted to take this one, I might be even using a bigger size, maybe the 4.5 inch size to cut it out. And once I've done that, then I could add different fabrics around it. And this is what I'm going to be showing you today, this technique where you'll be adding different strips. And this is a great way to use up scrap strips. So for example, you could do something like that on this particular piece. And again, you can make it as large as you'd like. So what do you start with when you're making this project? Well, we know we need some scrap fabrics, right? We need some strips, we know that. We know we need a centerpiece, but we also need a backing. Okay, it's a quilt-as-you-go method. So you want to take some batting as the backing. Now, I like to use just the batting for my backing, if you will, at this time, or for my foundation is really what I should say. I like to use my batting. And I will put my center piece in there, my vintage linen, and I will add the strips around it. Then I will add my backing. But if you want to add your backing behind the batting right now, feel free to do that. I like to do a little additional quilting at the end. So for example, in this piece, I will do some additional free motion quilting here, and I will just stitch in the ditch around some of these to attach that backing afterwards. But the choice is yours. But you do need a piece of batting for your foundation. So I've got a piece of batting here. And again, this will depend on the size that you want your finished size or approximate finished size. It should be a little bit bigger than what you want your finished size to be. So that will depend on the size of the project you want to make and how small or large your center vintage linen is. All right. So I did mention to you that I had another piece of this vintage linen. Let me get that out here. Here he is. So here's the other side, which is in a bit better shape, actually. Okay. So I need to decide what size I want to make this, or cut this, I should say. That's really what we're talking about here. And I think the 8.5 inch fussy cut window will work, or an 8.5 inch square is what we're going to cut. So the nice thing about using these templates is I can put them down, I can move it around until I get, about the same distance all around. So for example, I don't want to have it like this where it's offset. Oh, maybe I do. Again, choice is yours. I like to center them. Okay. So let me take my batting out because I want to do some cutting here. And if I leave the batting, I'm going to cut the batting at the same time. And that's not what I want to do. So once I've decided where I want this, I can then take the no-slip square template, place it inside. Okay. Make sure it's all down there. Remove the fussy cut window and then cut. All right, so I have some leftover scraps and there's some nice trim on here. So I'm going to keep this because I could use this for another project for sure. There's lots of linen left there. But here is my little center. So this is what I'm going to be starting with. Now, I need to put it on my batting, right? And again, the choice is up to you, but I like to center my linen on the batting. Now, you might not want to do that. Here's some other options. Maybe you want it off to one side and you want to fill more of one side up with your scrap fabrics. Choice is up to you. However, I do want to center it, I should say. Sure, I'm telling you what to do after saying the choice is yours. No. You decide. I like to center things, okay? So what I'm doing is I had the batting folded in four, and I'm just going to fold my vintage linen in four and then match up as best I can those marks, okay, on the two of them. Okay, does not have to be perfect. Perfect-ish is perfectly fine. All right, but we'll get that on there. All right, so the next step is to start adding my strips, and I'm just going to go around them in either a clockwise or counterclockwise fashion. It does not matter, but you're going to be adding with a quarter inch seam your first strip. You're going to be opening it up, and then you're going to be adding a decorative stitch to it to quilt it down. So let's go over to the sewing machine and I'll show you our next step. Now I'm at the machine. Today I'm using the Janome M17. So I want to tell you a little bit about how I've got that set up. And this also applies to different Janome models that may have the same features on it. So what I'm doing first is I am using the regular, or what we call a zigzag needle plate. It's the one that's got the open area in the center of it because I'm going to be using some decorative stitches. So what I want to do is make sure I've got a needle plate that will allow me to do that so I don't have to switch my needle plates back and forth. I'm also using the AD foot, the AccuFeed Flex regular foot that comes with this machine. I like to use this foot when I'm sewing strips on. It will also allow me to use the decorative stitches with the AccuFeed Flex system. And what I'm trying to do here is I'm trying to minimize the changes I need to make on the machine as I'm creating this project. So I need to have a quarter inch seam allowance. This will allow me to do that, and I'll just talk about those machine settings in a second here. And I also want to make sure that I can use the decorative stitches. So I don't want to have to be switching feet or needle plates back and forth as I do this project. I'm also using a 40 weight polyester thread. I'm going to use that both for the piecing and for the quilting of the decorative stitches. Okay, with me so far? Great. All right, let me put my needle plate back on. So how can I use the AccuFeed Flex system and foot to stitch decorative stitches? Because usually it's not going to let me do that. Well, there's an option on the menu on the display screen that you can choose, and this is for other Janome models as well. So when you're in the stitch, right now I'm in a patchwork piecing setting, but it doesn't matter where you are. At the top on this machine, there are what we call a hamburger menu, or three lines. And if you click on that, you're going to see what says manual dual feed setting. It's typically off. I'm going to put it on, and you hear it click, makes a little bit of a noise, and that's going to allow me to sew decorative stitches using this AD foot. Okay, so that's the first thing. All right, so now the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the home area, and I'm going to go into the sewing application mode, because the first thing we're going to do in this project is sew on a strip with the quarter inch seam. So I want to have a quarter inch seam setting. All right. So I go into that area. I go into the quilt area as well, and it's automatically going to choose the quarter inch straight stitch. So when I'm there, my needle, you can hear all this noise going on probably, my needle has moved over a bit, and so it has moved over, which will give me a quarter inch seam. So if I line up my fabric along the edge of this foot, I'm going to get a quarter inch seam. Okay, all good so far? Perfect. Now, let's take our batting. We've got our batting. We've got our vintage linen centered in the center of the batting, right? Or wherever you want it, okay? And now I need something, I need a strip of fabric, and I'm going with the blue again. I did pull some other colors, but I'm gonna go with the blue again. And I just wanna see what I've got here. If I wanna use this one or something different. Let's go with this guy. This looks a little more interesting to start with. All right, so doesn't matter where you start, but just start on a side, okay? So I'm gonna take my fabric, put it right sides down, and I'm lining it up along the edge of my vintage linen. Now, I can cut off this strip here, approximately at the end of that vintage linen that I've cut. All right, make sure it's lined up again. Now I'm just gonna go underneath my needle as I would normally do. Just gonna check my settings here for my stitch length. Okay, I've got it at 2. And I'm just gonna start stitching here and to get this stitch down. Okay, here we go. Okay, when I'm done, I can just cut my stitches. All right, there we go. There's our first little piece on there. All right, now I want to open this up, right? And I don't have my iron at my sewing machine, but what I do have is my Violet Craft seam roller. So you can check in the description below for a link to that. I use this all the time when I'm doing Quilt As You Go. Works very well. And it's just gonna keep it down there just where I need it, because the next step is to add the decorative stitches. And this is where it becomes really fun. So whether you have a lot of decorative stitch on your machine, or even if you have utility stitches, you can often change the stitch width and length, and it gives you a totally different looking stitch. So you can just have some fun with that. Okay, so and you can decide here, this is just a thin strip, so I'm just gonna put one down the center-ish of it, or you could put several different lines. So if I had a wider piece of fabric here, I might put several different lines of decorative stitches. So to get to my decorative stitches though, because I'm in my quilt mode right now, I'm going to go back out to home. I'm going to go to the ordinary sewing mode, and this will now give me access to all the decorative stitches. Okay, it's on utility, but I can click to the decorative stitch or the sewing area where it gives me all these decorative stitches to choose from. And this is probably the hardest part of the project, is deciding which decorative stitches to use. And I'm gonna use all kinds of different ones on this project, because why not, right? And don't forget, like I mentioned before, you can change the width and the length of them if you want to. Now, I'm just gonna keep it simple today, and I am just going to choose a stitch and go with the default setting on it, but you can have some fun, right? So I'm gonna go with H14, that's an heirloom stitch, H14. I'm just gonna run it kind of down the center here. I do need to be mindful that there's going to be a quarter inch seam here, so I don't wanna put it too far over, it might get sucked up in the seam allowance, you won't see all of it. So we're gonna go over a little further. Again, no stress on this, just put the stitches down, just have fun with it. Alright, so on this machine, I have a lock stitch button. If I push the lock stitch, it's going to complete the last part of that stitch, of that design, and then it's going to stop and do some tacking stitches, and that's what I did, and that's perfect. And then I can cut my stitches, and there we go. So that's what that looks like. Looks pretty nice, right? So that is one stitch, but we're going to keep going. So there's going to be lots of stitches going on here, right? So let's see if we can find another piece. Let's go back with this guy, and we're going to put him on here. So if you have, in this particular case, I just noticed that I've got a selvage on here. So if you have selvage on there, you want to make sure you cut that off. You don't want to stitch the selvage on. So you can just cut that off and discard that, and then you're ready to use that strip. All right, so this time we are not only covering the vintage linen, but we're covering that first strip that we put on, right? So we want to make sure that we go all the way past it. So sometimes I will just cut off the strip, you know, like not necessarily exactly where it needs to go, but just to get some extra fabric off, especially if I have a longer strip. And now, of course, I have to make some changes, right? I can't just start stitching or I'm going to be stitching that decorative stitch on again, right? So I have to make sure that I go back. The easiest way for me to do this, go back home, go with the sewing application mode, go into the quilt area, and get back to that quarter inch straight stitch. All right, so let's get this guy on. One thing to mention is, while I said I may not have cut the strip even with the first strip I put on, you can see it's longer, I don't want to stitch this all the way down, okay? I only want to stitch to the edge of this other first strip that was put on, the strip you're going across, as close to that as you can get. And you don't need to lock your stitches because you're going to have another strip that's going to be stitched on top of that, okay? So at this point in time, when I take it out, and I've got it stitched on there, I will cut it off approximately to the edge of that first strip. Okay, now what do? Open it up. You can see this is a bit wider strip. Okay, I may actually put more than one line of stitching in here. I'm going to put that down with that Violet Craft seam roller again. And now I need to adjust my machine again so that I'm in a decorative stitch mode, right? So back home we go. Let's go into the decorative stitches. Those different categories, heirloom, decorative, quilt, satin stitch. I would not do the satin stitches on here. They're too tight. You would need some stabilizer behind there. And they're going to take you a lot longer to do as well. The fancier the stitch, the thicker, the denser the stitch is, the longer it's going to take to stitch out for you. Oh, but here's a fun one. How about D19? Sounds like bingo, doesn't it? Under the D19. Okay, let's try this little guy here. And if I want to put more than one line of stitching in, I will look at my settings and see what the default setting is as far as stitch length and width. So on this particular one, it looks like the width is, let me just see here, no, the width is 5 and the length is 2.5. So I may want to make this a little narrower. Why don't we go to 4.5? I'm going to leave it at 2.5 for the length, but we'll make the width a little less. So you can see what that looks like. That looks kind of nice, right? So I could do another line of stitching there if I wanted to with that one, or maybe I want to choose and do something totally different. Why don't we choose and do something totally different? Because we can. Okay. Now this one I'm going to take down. This is as wide as it could go. It was at 9 millimeters wide. I'm going to take it down to 8, a little bit less. And we're going to start up here and see how this one looks. Okay, one thing I just want to point out to you, as I'm going along, I'm using this former line of stitching to line up the edge of my foot. So I'm lining up my edge of my foot along this line of stitching, along the little hills there, if you will, to keep the next line of stitching relatively straight. Again, when I push that lock stitch button, it finishes off the design and locks the stitches. So there we go. All right, that looks pretty nice, right? Yeah, you can have lots of fun with this. And you know, depending on what you've got in the center, like I have different floral decorative stitches that might be nice because I have a floral design in that vintage linen, right? All right, so the next thing I would do, of course, is continue going around and adding different strips of fabric. Always making sure that I switch my machine settings, okay? There'll be at least one time where you'll start off with that decorative stitch going forward. But we try to remember these things, right? Maybe put a post-it note in your machine. Might be helpful. All right, back to our quarter inch seam. So you want to stitch along here. Okay. My stitches off, cut that strip now even with the previously stitched one, or relatively even with it. Open up my little piece here. Get that seam roller working. And you could press these if you wanted to. I'm just too lazy to go back to my pressing area to do that. So if you're lazy like me, the seam roller works very well. Okay, now we need to go and find another nice stitch to add to this. So yes, I have to go back a few times back and forth my machine, but I don't have to change out my needle plate. I don't have to change out my foot. Well, how about there's a little one that's a little bird. Now that's kind of cute. So there's an animals one, and this is A27. So let's try this little guy, see what he looks like. All right, so here's our little bird on a wire, if you will. So that's quite cute, right? And that just fills that in very nicely. All right, so I'm going to show you how to put one more on here because I want to show you something a little bit different here as far as the stitch choice. All right, so we can put this guy on here. All right, so what do I have to do? Yes, I have to get my strip on, but I also have to change back to my quarter inch stitch setting. Been doing pretty good so far, I think. Now, when I'm going to line this one up, you can see that this is a little bit longer here. I'm not really concerned about that. I could cut it off if I wanted to, but really I just want to make sure I'm lined up with the edge of that linen. So I will just make sure it's long enough there and then just follow the edge of the linen. That'll be just fine. Okay, so let's get this down here. All right, I'll cut that off. And we'll open this up like we've been doing all the way along. You can see already we've got our first round done and we're getting bigger, right? All right, so I want to show you something different here, and this is a good fabric to show you this on. So you may not have a lot of decorative stitches on your sewing machine. Well, that's okay, not a big deal. You probably have utility stitches on your machine. Most machines do, and you can have some fun with those as well. I know they don't look terribly exciting, but they can be kind of fun. And you can change up the sizes on them, right? So you can make them longer, wider, that type of thing, as I mentioned for the third time now, I think, actually, because I really want to encourage you to do that. So I am taking this one. This is a decorative stitch on my machine. It's utility, or I should say it's a utility stitch, U19. That looks kind of interesting, and I'm going to change it up a little bit. So by changing these, you can get quite a different look sometimes on them than what they start off with. Okay, I'm going to change this to a 4 width and a 4.5 is what I want. There we go, 4.5. It's actually jumping by 2 on all the time. That's interesting. 4.6 then we'll go with. Okay, I'm not going to argue with the machine. Okay, we're going to go with 4.6. So I just want to see what this one's going to look like when I put it down, because I don't think you're going to look at it and go, yes, that's a utility stitch. So let's try and see. So here we go with this stitch here. So it kind of comes down and crosses itself. It's probably hard to see on that, but it's kind of an interesting looking stitch. I think it's probably for stretch fabric. I'm not a garment sewer, but I believe that's probably what it is used for. If you know what it's used for, let me know in the comments below. So that looks quite nice, right? So it's a decorative stitch. I mean, a utility stitch. Okay, I'm stuck on decorative stitches, quite obviously. It's a utility stitch. And then sometimes you even have utility stitches that are like 3 rows. Those can look really nice when applied to a project like this as well. So this is the first round. I will just continue adding strips. Now, the one thing to keep in mind is as you continue adding to this, as you can tell, it's getting bigger. So your strips are going to need to be longer no matter what size you start with in the center. You have to have longer strips. Now, if you don't have a strip that's long enough, of course, you can always join them together. So for example, if I had this little piece, all these are longer, but if I didn't have enough, I could just take a couple of pieces here and sew them together, you know, put them right size together, sew them to the quarter inch seam, and then I could use them to put along my piece if I needed a longer piece. So let's say, for example, I only had a couple of short pieces here. If I put these two together, let's just pretend, put them together like that, you would get this type of a look. And it's going to be kind of a scrappy look anyway, because you're adding all these different fabric strips around it. So that will look just fine. As a matter of fact, I think it adds a little more interest to the project. So this is what I would continue to do. I would keep building this out until I've covered my foundation. Okay, at that point in time, as I mentioned earlier, you probably want to have your foundation cut a little bit bigger. So once you've covered the whole foundation, it's time to trim it down. So you would just use your ruler, your regular rotary cutter and regular ruler, and trim it down to whatever size you want. And then you could either bind it, which most of us would probably do, or, and don't forget, if you haven't, is like if you were doing it like I am and you don't have a backing on it, you need to put the backing on at that point in time and do a bit of additional quilting to hold that all together. So for example, I might go in and do some extra quilting in here, maybe some echo quilting or some free motion little swirls, maybe even pebbles, something like that. And then I could easily stitch in the ditch along, doesn't have to be all of them, but it could be if you wanted, all the different strips have been put on there. You could do that. That would definitely be sufficient to hold that batting foundation to your backing, all right? Or if you wanted to, you could do something like put this on a canvas frame. So you can buy those canvases that you would paint. Instead, you could take your project, your wall hanging, and put it on there, fold it around the back, and just you can just staple it on, actually. Makes it very easy. And if you were doing something like that, you definitely want to make sure you've got enough room. You might even want to add some extra fabric just stitched around the edges of your batting to use to cover that canvas frame. So I hope you enjoyed this project about using a vintage linen to make a new wall hanging. And I just want to draw your attention to something that you may have seen on my videos. There's a heart with a dollar sign in it, and that's your opportunity to support the Chatterbox Quilts YouTube channel. For as little as $2, you can make a donation that helps me to buy the items I use to create these free videos for you. Now, I've shown you what to do with vintage linen and how to use your decorative stitches on this project, but you might be wondering what else you can do with the decorative stitches on your sewing machine. Well, don't worry, I've got you covered. Check out this video that will give you all the important information that you need. For more helpful quilting information, be sure to go to my website at www.chatterboxquilts.com.